Hello guys, welcome to my channel and my new video. Today you are going to learn lots of stuff, so please do like this video and don't forget to share this video with your friends also so that they can learn too. If you have just stumbled upon this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also hit the bell icon so that you are immediately notified when I post a new video. Happy learning! Hello friends, welcome to this new video. So I've taken up this topic of Doppler effect, where I'm going to tell a very awesome trick to remember the formulas of Doppler effect. So actually, Doppler effect is the phenomena where an apparent frequency change happens because of the relative motion between the observer and the source. So let's see what is the general formula, and then I'm going to tell the trick to remember all the formulas. So let's start. So actually, the original formula is, from which all other formulas are derived, is that F is equal to V plus or minus V naught divided by V plus or minus Vs. F dash equal to this times F, right? This is actually the general formula from which all other formulas are derived. So in the first case, let me take that observer and the source are moving away from each other. Observer and the source, they are moving away from each other. So in this case, we know that the frequency, apparent frequency, has to be the least, right? Because both are moving away from each other. So what we do is we make this part as least as possible, because this F is a constant. So we need to make this part in the bracket to be the least in this case, right? So that can be done in this way. F dash is equal to V minus V naught divided by V plus Vs. So clearly we are making the numerator the least and denominator the most, so that this becomes the as minim, this becomes as minimum as possible, right? So the next case is that observer and the source are moving towards each other. So what do we do in this case? All we have to do is we have to maximize this. So that can be done in this way. F dash is equal to V plus V naught divided by V minus Vs times F. We are decreasing the numerator as much as possible and increasing the numerator as much as possible, right? So the next two cases are what is a problem for everybody. The third and the fourth case. This is that observer follows the source, and the fourth case will be the source follows the observer. The source follows the observer. Now, how to remember this? How to decide the signs for these two particular cases? So for this, I'd like to bring a little bit of chemistry, not too much. Just that, remember the sulfate ion, SO4, 2 negative, right? So clearly what this depicts is, the source follows the observer, then negative sign has to come. That is what SO4, 2 negative says. That is valid for this case, right? So source follows the observer, then negative sign has to come. So the formula will be F dash is equal to V minus V naught divided by V minus Vs. So that will be the formula. So for this, obviously it will be plus, right? Maybe you can remember as OS plus, you can take it as operating system or anything. Just remember OS plus, but you can easily remember sulfate ion because you have read chemistry. So for this, the formula will be F dash is equal to V plus V naught divided by V plus Vs times the original frequency. So this was the trick to remember all the formulas of Doppler effect when there is a relative motion between the observer and the source. So thanks a lot for watching this video. Thank you.